Matter exists in three main states on Earth: solid, liquid, and gas. Matter can be physically changed by adding or removing heat. If enough heat is added or removed, there can be a change in the state. For example, a solid can change into a liquid, and a liquid into a gas. In our everyday lives, we make use of the physical properties of matter, which sometimes involves a change of state. Let's look at some of the ways we use matter in its various states. One of the earliest ways we were able to move people and freight quickly across the land was with steam trains. Steam trains are powered by heating a boiler with coal. The high-pressure steam produced by the boiler provides energy, from the rapid movement of its particles to a steam engine, which converts the energy of high-pressure steam into motion. Steam engines were used to power many different machines in the past. Then there's modern-day transport. In areas where air temperatures fall to 0 degrees Celsius and below, the water in the cooling systems of cars can freeze, because water turns into a solid at that temperature. Adding substances to water can change some of its properties. For instance, adding antifreeze to the cooling system prevents the water from turning into a solid. When substances dissolve in water, like salt, for example, they lower the freezing point of water. So it takes lower temperatures than 0 degrees Celsius to make a solution containing water turn into a solid. Antifreeze works in this way. It's mostly made of a substance known as ethylene glycol. It dissolves into the water and lowers the water's freezing point to well below the temperature that a car would normally be exposed to. This means the water remains a liquid and can continue to cool the engine, preventing overheating. Antifreeze also raises the boiling point of the water to prevent it from boiling over in high temperatures. In this situation, we can refer to antifreeze as a coolant. Salt in solution with water lowers its freezing point. Seawater freezes at about -2 degrees Celsius compared to 0 degrees Celsius for pure water. This property of salt can be used to manage icy surfaces. If there is ice on a road or other surface due to cold weather conditions, it can be melted to liquid water by adding salt. Because salt, in solution with water, requires lower temperatures for it to freeze. Different substances have a wide range of boiling and melting points. Distillation is a technique that uses different boiling points to separate out substances. Water can be purified by distilling it. Seawater has many dissolved salts and minerals in it. If we wanted to purify it for drinking, we could distill it. A simple distillation setup, like this one, shows how this process works. Seawater is being heated here. At a little more than 100 degrees Celsius, it boils and steam evaporates, traveling up the glass tube here, before being carried through the cooling tube here. The cold water running around the outside of the cooling tube cools the steam down, and it condenses back into water. The purified water drips into this flask here. Why is it purified? Because the impurities, the salts and the minerals, have higher boiling points than the temperature the Bunsen burner can reach. So they remain in solid form over on this side of the distillation apparatus. Thermal distillation can be used to desalinate salty water, such as seawater, and turn it into drinking water. Distillation is used in a number of other ways in industry. For example, refineries distill crude oil, which is taken from the earth and made into a wide range of different products, like fuels, glues, solvents, and industrial chemicals, which all have different boiling points. Gases can be compressed. Most liquids, on the other hand, cannot be easily compressed. This principle is used in hydraulic systems. They work like this. A piston forces hydraulic liquid, which is usually a type of oil, into a cylinder, which is connected via a hydraulic line to another piston and cylinder. As the liquid is forced down one cylinder, it moves around the lines to the other cylinder, forcing the piston to rise. Hydraulic systems can be used to drive different types of machines and to lift and move incredibly heavy objects. humans use physical changes of state of matter for many purposes. Steam engines are one example of how matter can change state when heat is added, and the energy can be used to drive machines. Antifreeze lowers the freezing point and elevates the boiling point of water in a car's cooling system, ensuring that the engines do not freeze or overheat. Salt on ice lowers the freezing point of ice and melts it, allowing us to travel safely on roads. Distillation can be used to purify seawater for drinking and other industrial applications. Hydraulic equipment uses liquids that can't be compressed to drive machinery and move heavy objects.
If you liked this video, you can find it and so many more at ClickView.net. Sign up for free today.